Good evening. I hope this finds you all well. I'd like to remind you that this evening's First Friday event is being sponsored by the Woodside Arts and Culture Committee, a group of volunteers here in the town of Woodside trying to provide interesting program for you to enjoy. And this evening, we have a very exciting program brought to you with the Costanza-Fong Family String Trio. So we'll have cello, violin, and viola representing some wonderful music for you. Now, the poet once said, where words leave off, music begins. So with that, I'm going to turn it over and let you enjoy the Costanza-Fong Family String Trio. Thank you again for joining us.
Hi, I'm Debra Fong.
And I'm Christopher Costanza. It's exciting for us to perform on the Woodside Arts and Culture Committee First Friday series again. Since we can't be with you in person this time, we've enjoyed putting together a very diverse program of videos made from our home over the past year.
We feel fortunate to have been able to make music together as a family during this extended pandemic. After Isabella headed back to Toronto in June 2020 to resume viola studies at the Glenn Gould School, Chris and I have continued to create solo and duo videos for ourselves and to share with others. Our program today begins with Chris performing some Bach.
Ah, great place to start, Bach. I had a terrific time presenting the Bach cello suites on this concert series in May of 2019. Here are two of my favorite solo Bach movements, the Sarabands and two Bourées from suite number 3 in C major.
Thank you.
Composer whose name may not be familiar to you. This is the first movement marked Allegro from Arthur Honegger's Sonatina for violin and cello, composed in 1932.
Honegger was a Swiss composer who was born in France and lived most of his life in Paris. He was a member of the notable group of French composers that called themselves Les Six.
He was also widely known to be a train enthusiast, like Chris.
Thank you.
Next, our Family String Trio performs an arrangement of the Pie Jesu movement from Maurice Duruflé's magnificent Requiem, Opus 9, which was completed in 1947.
This movement was originally scored for organ, solo cello, and mezzo-soprano solo. I made this arrangement in the summer of 2020 because I had so enjoyed playing and recording the original version of the full Requiem in 2019 with my Stanford colleagues, one of whom was Debra.
Thank you.
Beethoven composed three duos for clarinet and bassoon, which were not published until after his death.
We now offer the first movement, Allegro Commodo, from the C major duo in the popular violin and cello version. It's a joyous movement and a rousing conversation between the two instruments.
In 1920, the French impressionist composer Maurice Ravel composed a duo for violin and cello dedicated to the memory of Claude Debussy, who had died in 1918. The original version was a single movement, and over the course of 2 years, Ravel expanded the piece into a four-movement work that he entitled Sonata for Violin and Cello.
We have a special love for this work, which we first played together when we were undergraduate students at the New England Conservatory of Music in Boston. Today, we're happy to present the first two movements, marked Allegro, followed by Très Vif, or Very Lively. ¶¶
Thank you.
have been great fans of the music of Olivier Messiaen for decades. In fact, Chris and I had the wonderful pleasure of meeting and working with Messiaen when he visited Boston in 1986.
Messiaen was a remarkably prolific French composer whose music is characterized, among other things, by distinctively beautiful open-sounding harmonies and textures and colors that are evocative of nature, birds in particular. O Sacrum Convivium is a short motet in four voices, composed in 1937, based on a Latin text. We had great fun transforming the four-voice vocal version into a string trio.
And now for some unabashedly romantic duos by the Russian composer Reinhold Glier.
These three brief pieces are from a set of eight pieces Glier composed for violin and cello in 1909. The pieces are entitled Gavotte, Berceuse, and Canzonetta. ¶¶ Program ends with Franz Schubert's String Trio in B-flat major, a single movement work composed in 1816. This is quintessentially Schubert, with beautiful harmonies, lovely melodic material, and an uplifting spirit.
It's a piece such as this one that brings us joy and makes us grateful to have the incredible privilege to be able to play music together as a family.
Thank you.
so much for joining us for today's virtual program.
We very much look forward to seeing you in person when we can all gather again safely.
Wow, another wonderful program. Thank you so much, Costanza-Fong family, for bringing us that wonderful music interlude for our Friday evening. You know, Albert Schweitzer was an interesting gentleman, and all that he did for the people of Africa to make their lives a little easier, but he was a great fan of music, and he once said, "There are two means of refuge from the misery of life, music and cats." So I'm glad we were able to at least provide the music part. Those of you who enjoy cats, I'll leave you to it. So thank you very much for joining us this evening. And I look forward to seeing you next month, where we have a wonderful artist, Ronell Roberts, who will be giving us a fantastic program talking about his art. So until that time, have a great month. Stay safe, stay healthy. Remember, wearing a mask not only protects you, but it protects others. So take care, have a pleasant evening. Good night.